Hello students, so last time we are discussing about, we are giving the introduction of phase modulation and frequency modulation. We are getting this expression of phase modulated signal and frequency modulation signal, and we are also discussing about this modulation index of phase modulated signal and frequency modulated signal. So in this lecture we are going to discuss the further concept of this phase modulation and frequency modulation, the power requirement of phase and frequency modulation. So all of you know how power is calculated. So in this, if we see the general expression of frequency modulation and phase modulation, we are getting the one of the a cosine of something, and phase modulation, frequency modulation is a cosine of something. So both are similar kind of functions. So if we find out the power of these two signal, then both will be the same. Both are periodic signal, and we know that if a cos theta will be a signal, it is a power signal because it is a periodic in nature, and its value will vary from for cos theta it will vary from this plus a to minus a. Okay, and for periodic signal, this it is a standard result that power of the signal is a square by 2. Okay, so similarly, if we want to calculate the power of phase modulation and frequency modulated signal, or both have the same power requirement, we can easily get that v square of fmt. So a square cos square has the power of half, so it will be a square by, power will be a square by 2. Okay, and it is also can be written as arm root mean square of a square. So it is an important point to note here that this power requirement is independent of modulation index. Okay, and it is not for single phase modulation, it is both for phase modulation and frequency modulation. Okay, so it is a single point to remember that the power requirement for phase modulation and frequency modulation are independent of modulation index. So some important point to be noted during the frequency modulate should be noted during the study of this frequency modulated and phase modulated signal. So first of all, that frequency modulated and phase modulated signal can be inseparable, because for a signal, any variation in frequency will cause variation in phase and vice versa. Okay, so you can't say that any signal is frequency modulated signal or phase modulated signal. So we can't say that it is a purely FM or phase modulated signal. Okay, so both signals are inseparable. So next point is that if we consider a modulating signal like this is a modulating signal. If we approach this modulating signal, is this. This is a modulating signal. If we are approaching this modulating signal by two ways. For example, in first way, we are integrating it. What we have the ft dt, and we are getting this g1t. We use this g1t to modulate the phase modulated with carrier, with this g1t. We use this g1t for phase modulation. So when we use this g1t for phase modulation, we are getting this in respect of this ft, we are getting this narrow band frequency modulated signal, and this is also indirect method of generation of frequency modulation, which is also known as Armstrong method. Okay, second approach is differentiation of this signal g2t, and by this g2t we are frequency modulated the signal, and we are getting this phase modulated signal. As I have told you earlier also, when we are deriving the general expression of frequency modulated signal, we are integrating the function, and then we are phase modulated, and we are getting the frequency modulated signal expression. So this is the same thing, and this is the same thing that how we are approaching for the generation of frequency modulated signal, aur ye Armstrong method bhi kehlata hai, theek hai. लेकिन दूसरे केस में हम क्या करेंगे, हम डिफरेंशिएशन करेंगे, इसका फ्रीक्वेंसी मॉड्यूलेशन करेंगे इसके साथ, कैरियर वेव का g2t के साथ, तो हमें फेस मॉड्यूलेटेड सिग्नल मिलेगा. लेकिन ये जो सेकंड अप्रोच है, इट इज नॉट प्रेफर्ड, नेवर प्रेफर्ड, बिकॉज because the differentiation leads to more noise component. Okay, so it is not preferred for phase modulation for this like this to achieve to get this phase modulation by this approach, because by differentiation it will lead to more noise component. On the other hand, if we do this integrated approach, then not the integrated approach, by integration method we are getting the by Armstrong method, we are having lead to less noise component will be there. So in this way it can be generated frequency modulation signal. So next point is the most important point is this power content. As I told you, that power content in frequency modulation signal and phase modulated signal is always constant, and since they are constant amplitude signal, the power is always independent of modulation index. I have told you that A square by 2 will be the power, so it will always be a independent of modulation index. And the important point to be noted here is that in phase modulated, the modulation index is directly related to the amplitude of modulating signal. Jo maine aapko bataya ki modulation index is directly related to amplitude of this frequency amplitude of this modulating signal, whereas the modulation index in this frequency modulated signal will directly depend on the isme to karega amplitude of modulating signal mein to depend karega, but it will also depend on the inversely proportional to the this frequency of the maximum modulating frequency of the modulating signal. So these are the few points that has to be keep in mind while we are studying the frequency modulation and phase modulation. So thank you very much.